Next on the program, we have Nicholas Mitchell.
Hey, Pastor. I'm doing good. How about you? I just want to come over here and tell you that I love you. And ever since the first time I come to this church, it was like, every time you preach, you hit it. Every time, because it's like, every time my grandma said, I'm getting in my deal, man. So, every time you preach, you just hit it. I'll be thinking my grandma be coming to you and telling you what I did. Yeah, but you just hit it, and I love you for that, because ever since, all the preaching you've been doing, it's like I've been changing and becoming a new person, a new man. And I just want to thank you for that. And I want to thank the Lord for you. I want to thank you that he brought you to this earth and to be my pastor and my father. And I love you. Amen. Happy Father.
Next on the program, we have me. Well, I'm really not on the program, but, you know, I put myself on it anyway. So, Pastor, you have known me for over 20 years. I'm 24 now, so I think I came to the church when I was like 3 years old, maybe two, three, somewhere around there. And you have watched me grow and grow and grow and grow. You have prayed for me. You have taught me so many things that you probably don't even know that you taught me, but I was like, I know it because you taught me that. And today is Father's Day, so we honor all of the fathers here today, but right now we're gonna honor the father of our fathers. It's not an easy job and an easy task, but you do it so well. So we thank you for that. I thank you for that. I also thank my father for allowing you to be another father to me. I'm not done growing yet. So, you know, I'm still gonna be coming to you, asking you for things, asking you, so what do you think about that? Or, them kids. And that's all I can say is those kids. So I just thank you for taking on the job and continuing to allow God to show you what to say, to tell us what we need to know right when we need to know it. So I thank you for that, and I'm sure everybody else thanks you for that. So next we have a video presentation. So.
Let us love one another. Reverend Womack is one who loves everybody. Happy Father's Day, Reverend Womack.
Praise the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing and we're glad in it. To all of you, great, wonderful fathers at End Time Harvest, I am wishing you a very, very wonderful, happy Father's Day. And in particular, to the chief, Pastor Melvin Womack. I love my friend. My wife and I are traveling right now in Southeast Asia, and we are bringing you these greetings from Yangon, Myanmar, formerly known as Burma. You know, as we were traveling through the airports in Bangkok and in Nepal to get here, there was a sign that struck me at the airport. And this sign was an exclusive sign made in honor of the monks and Buddhist priests. And precisely what it said was, they had a space assigned for them to rest in between flights. And also, as we went from gate to gate, they had special seats, couches really, that are exclusively reserved in honor of these monks and Buddhist priests. And as I saw that, it struck me on this wonderful Father's Day. The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 5, in verse 17, that the elders that rule well are worthy of double honor, especially those that rule and teach, or rather those that labor in word and in doctrine. And Melvin Womack, my chief, pastor, father in his house, you are a man who has labored in word and doctrine, and I believe if the world can honor Buddhist priests and monks by giving them a special place of rest and blessing and reverence in their society, you, my friend, deserves the honor that comes from above, from God. And therefore, End Time Harvest, this is what I want us to do today, to honor this man of God, Melvin Womack, as a father in the house, as a friend, counselor, pastor, teacher, a man of God who has served with devotion and faithfulness in this house. Let us honor him. How do we do that? Honor is a word in the Bible that carries action. In Thailand, they honored the monks and the priests by doing something special for them. They created a space of honor for them to rest. Yes? The Bible here in 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 18, gives us a clue on what to do. What did it say? It said in verse 18, we should not muzzle the ox that treads out the corn, and that the workman is worthy of his hire. Yes. So on this special day, on this Father's Day, join me, End Time Harvest, in honoring my chief, my beloved son, Pastor Melvin Womack. Please, I know you may have given an offering this morning, but I'm asking you now to join me in this wonderful day to give a special seed of honor, sow a seed of honor in respect of Melvin Womack. Would you do that for me? Please, thank you very much. Let me just pray for you now for your obedience. Let me just pray for you now. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for this wonderful privilege that we have, an opportunity to be a blessing to your servant, your son, Pastor Melvin Womack, on this Father's Day. We receive him as a gift from God. We thank you, Father God, for your grace that's upon his life to continue to teach and be a blessing to us. And so, Lord, in return today, as a day of honor, we are sowing seed into his life. We thank you that this seed will refresh him, will bless him, will bring him joy and satisfaction. And God, for our obedience, I thank you, Lord God, that you bless everyone who will participate to be a blessing to your servant. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for joining me in being a blessing to your pastor, my son, God's servant. Thank you so much. I really, really do appreciate that. And again, once more, to all the fathers in the house, have a great, wonderful, fulfilled, and blessed Father's Day. We love you. God bless you. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to his name. Amen. it is easy to give thanks to real fathers. It's not a task, it's not a chore. It's what we should do, and therefore it's just fluid. It's no struggle at all. Amen. Were you guys able to get the song? Okay, all right, amen. There's a song, I don't know if you've heard of that or not, it's a simple song, Good, Good Father. And it just speaks to my heart, and it, to me, it's a song to our Heavenly Father.
Dirk Spindler, somewhere on a beach tour with special...
That's not it, but it embodies what we as fathers in the earth should be, how we should be perceived by our children.
Guest Randy Houser, Cam, and Tucker Beathard coming to a city near you.
If they can, if not, then we'll, I'm confident Faith will play it for you later. Amen.
Get tour dates at LiveNation.com.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never. Good Father, it's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you, it's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for it.
Yeah. Thank you. Glory. Hallelujah. God is so good. Words cannot express, and it's not to be cliche, it just cannot express what I've received, what we've received through a yielded vessel. Some may struggle with what we're doing here today, but let me just give you Bible 101. Bible 101 says that Adam was to be God's representation in the earth, and every time Adam's children saw Adam, they saw God. It's just that simple. So when you find a man that is doing all that he can to emulate God in the earth, then that's a man to be honored. Because that's the man, when God began to restore what had been lost with Abraham, and he said, those that bless you, I'll bless them. He said, through Abraham, the nations would be blessed. So we thank God for a man that is reversing the curse in Malachi 4 and 6. The heart of the father is turned to the sons. To the sons. Therefore, it's easy for us as sons to have our hearts turned to the father. Every child desires to have a father. What is life without a father? Some may have never known a father. If you haven't, there are brothers in here that can be a father. But to have the love of a father, to have the confidence to know that all is well, to hear the father's voice, amen. So, Dad, we thank you. We appreciate you for the sacrifice. And we know that God will reward you more than we ever can. But we want to, as there again in Malachi 1 and 6 says, if I be a father, then where is my honor? So we honor you today. In Jesus' name, amen. Love you.
Sincerity that I feel in the atmosphere, spirit of weeping that only comes from the Holy Spirit. And I look at each one of you and I'm thanking God for my family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are my family. Hallelujah. So we just thank God for you. I thank God for whatever you've done, monetary. I thank God for that, but just the honor of it. Words well spoken, Pastor Davis, and the honor of it. And even to hear my spiritual father speak those things means so much to me. It just makes me want to run on a little while longer. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to thank my wife for helping me to sustain, to keep going. Amen. For Praise God and my kids. Amen. And all the fathers in the house, I honor you. And I think you know that by now. I really appreciate you. And I appreciate the stand. As I alluded to, the fact that it's not good to be in a church where it's 99% women, because he created them male and female. So I do honor you, fathers, all the fathers in the house. We thank God for you. And let's just give them a hand clap. My prayer is that we continue to grow, and men like just finished speaking, that these will be prototypes, and this church will be full of fathers, strong men, and we just burst at the seam with men that are upright and upstanding, spiritual giants in the Lord, of all races and kind, men, praise God, and I honor you all. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. I want to thank God for my family. Thank God for my daughters. My daughters are here. My son is not here, but we just thank God for them being here today. Y'all raise your hand. And my grandkids. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We love y'all. Amen. Praise God. Let's do our exercise here. Open your arms. Yeah, see, Bro Scott knew what to do automatically. I didn't even have to tell you. Just do it. Yeah. Praise God. Amen. Okay, ready to close them to your bosom now? Amen. Amen. Let's be me loving you. And I love you, and I'm going to continue to love me, and I'm like George Wallace, and there's nothing you can do about it.
I'll be cake in the back after the benediction.
Praise God. Let's once again give the newlyweds a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. You guys just look so beautiful together, and we're just looking forward to all the blessings that God has in store for you. We love you. Amen. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for this blessed day, God. We thank you, Lord, for this day that has been set aside to honor all of the fathers, Lord God. And Father, truly you gave unto us a marvelous gift, God, when you placed man on this earth. And Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for the blessing that you've given unto us in the set man, the father, that you've placed in our lives. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Words can express, Lord, our gratitude in terms of how he pours into our lives, oh God. Lord, cause him to understand our gratitude and our love and our thankfulness in terms of the sacrifices that he makes for us, oh God. He and mother on a daily basis, Lord. Father, we ask that you just yet continue to build, oh God, restore, fortify, oh God, in the name of Jesus, and bless them all the way around in Jesus' name. Lord, we love you first and foremost, oh God, but Pastor, we want you to know that we love you too. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray all things. Amen. Amen.